Hello and welcome to Classic Judging by the Cover, the series that unravels the ancient world like a necrophile in an Egyptian tomb, where we'll be judging Dig Dug by the Cover. This episode has the alternative title, A Guide to Scooting Around Highly Suspect Imagery. Dig Dug is a classic arcade game centered around sticking a long hose into monsters and inflating them until they burst, which even with all the context in the world is equal parts nightmarish and erotic, like having sex with a mutant hybrid of David Hasselhoff and a scorpion. The art for the Atari version bravely gets the point across in about as dry a manner as you could possibly get. The defiant air about Dig Dug's posture and expression isn't in the least bit sexual, while the pipe appears to be inserted into what's most likely the ball monster's mouth. Although this interpretation is largely informed by that rather unfortunate extremity we can see poking out from underneath, which may well be the ball monster equivalent of a red rocket. Still, the Green Dragon's reaction indicates that this scenario is distressing and not erotic. It seems to be expressing guilt and horror at having chosen to ride upon the shoulder of a crazed air pump wielding lunatic. Let's not get distracted by this extremely perplexing tagline, the underground arcade chomping game, which makes it sound like an illicit backstreet pie-eating contest. Things only start to go really downhill as we move to the art for the Atari 5200 version, which has taken precisely the same scene but switched the monsters around. Again, the manner in which the pipe has been inserted into the monster is about as non-sexual as such a thing can be, but it's rather let down by the pose Dig Dug has chosen to adopt, with his arse conspicuously pointed up towards a second monster, and a look on his face that seems to say, "Hey, are we getting this bugger trainer rolling or what?" For its part, the unattached monster looks on not with distress, but a rather interpretive expression of shy nervousness. Me? The caboose of the bugger train? This is all moving so fast! What also doesn't help is that this scene appears to be taking place inside a gigantic rectum. Hey, I'm no prude! You want to camp out in a monster's butthole to live out your bugger train stroke inflation fantasies, then as long as consent forms are signed, then neither I nor the law need take an interest. I just worry about the message this might send to young ball monsters. I mean, take a look at the cover for the Japanese Famicom version. It's not even a stretch to say this looks dodgy, no pun intended. The inlet for the inflation pipe is clearly smack between the monster's legs. The monster is also depicted with little red cheek marks, which is standard Japanese cartoon imagery for being embarrassed by one's own sexual arousal. Dig Dug has a similar thing going on as he frantically works the little pump between his legs, but I think my favourite detail is how downright incensed he looks about all this. God damn it, I said work the shaft, not the head! I'm on the vinegar stroke, stop looking at me! Yes, granted he might be incensed by the dragon breathing fire at him, although he does seem to have deflected the tongue of fire with his firm heroic buttocks, and in any case, the dragon's wink indicates it was trying to be flirtatious. Assuming that is supposed to be a wink, I suppose it could be very distressed about the Tetris block lodged in its eye. Interestingly enough, this art was reproduced on the cover of the MSX version, whatever that was, in a case of the previously featured practice of redrawing an existing cover for the sake of looking busy, and possibly in this case to look a bit less like the cover was drawn by someone going crazy with the Photoshop line function. You'll note that this image has been enhanced by giving the red ball monster realistically organic-looking feet, which, if anything, has only made the situation slightly weirder. Suggestiveness reaches a crescendo with the Thunder Mountain PC Booter version, again whatever that was, which depicts two green dragon monsters who appear to be fighting over Mr. Doug's resplendent proxy wang. There's even two little effects here representing droplets of saliva spraying from the foreground dragon's eager slurping lips. Mr. Doug himself wears the fierce, determined expression of an alpha male who just wants his dick sucked and isn't bothered who does it. So if this argument goes on any longer, he's going to have to smack some bitches into line. There is also an object falling from above that appears to be a disembodied hairy ballsack. That is pretty much the only thing it could be. Except perhaps a dented heart-shaped chocolate box covered in ants. But in our final box art, the Datasoft PC Booter version, we find what might as well be the epilogue to this sorry saga, which depicts a surreal Eraserhead-style scene where Mr. Doug is confronted by the baby born of his shameful dalliances, still connected to his love pump by a tube with much of the umbilical cord about it, which appears to be in the process of ascending to a higher plane of existence. I am the Star Child, born of the love twixt dragon and pump. Through my eternal gaze shall all sinners be judged and punished by my infinite falling bollocks.